The dominant or most well-known sheep in Australia is the Merino, which has been bred for wool production. However, there's now a lot of British-bred sheep as well, which primarily are bred for meat production. Fine wool Merinos, which are like what we breed, go into men's suits and girls' fine jumpers and predominantly clothing. And then British-bred sheep still produce wool. It's just much stronger and wouldn't normally be used as much for clothing.
It's very good wool though. It might be short, but it's very fine. It's fine quality, and it's used mostly for filling doonas, and it's used for carpets and where you need a shorter fibre. It's also used as a blend with longer fibres because it's so strong, and it gives the blend then a great strength. We shear once a year, and we shear about November. We like to get the wool off then, to help the sheep, to stop the grass seeds. Wool is graded in from fine wool down to coarse wool. Australia's really fine wool, it's fantastic. It's in huge demand from the top fashion houses in Europe. And then the coarser wools are used for carpet making, for filling duvets, and for all the other purposes that you might, you know, want a wool filling.
Mini Jumbuck's a wool bedding company based in Narracourt, SA. We manufacture wool quilts, underlays and pillows, and we distribute them nationally and also export overseas. We've been around since the mid-70s, so we're probably pushing 40 years. We started off in Narracourt and we've never seen a reason to leave a regional town. A lot of people think we should be based in the metro areas because of the size of what we do and who we are, but there's something about that aura of being based in a small town for what we do here. With our branding, the Mini Jumbuck logo has always featured a ram's head, so that's been a strong factor in our branding. We believe over the years we've developed quite a strong brand name and quite recognisable. Our wool is sourced nationwide, and we probably go through 400 or 500 tonne a year, so we're big users in that sense. Probably one of the largest users in Australia of sourcing wool. We're certainly not making any suits with what we use. We use a crossbred Downs wool, which is about low 30s in micron. So in comparison to, say, people with the clothing industry, they'll be using like maybe 17, 18 micron. So certainly a bit coarser. It's purchased by a buyer such as Michelle & Sons. They do the processing of the wool. So when I say processing, they pre-wash, pre-scour the wool. They'll treat the wool for any allergies, dust mites, etc. So we get it in a nice healthy state, and then we can utilise it to make our quilts. When we do receive it, we have a carding plant here. So the carding plant, it pretty well teases the wool. It gets it in a state which looks like berry floss or candy floss. So we're getting layers of wool with plenty of air pockets, plenty of loft, and that's what gives wool its properties, which we utilise in the quilts. We find wool quilts are a great insulator, and they suit different body temperatures, different climates. So whether you're a hot sleeper or a cold sleeper, wool is ideal in that sense. Other fillings, such as whether it be down or polyester, they don't breathe as well. Well, they don't breathe full stop, really. As we know, wool's a natural fibre which is environmentally friendly, it's sustainable, a renewable resource, and totally biodegradable. Peak production, we can put out about 3,000 quilts a week along with 400 pillows a day. We have a workforce of about 35 to 40 odd people, Monday to Friday. We can always put in a Saturday morning shift if need be, but even those kind of numbers, we can do that with one shift a day. I know when I started here 15 years ago, we were doing three shifts a day around the clock. We still had similar employment numbers. We weren't doing any bigger numbers, but just over the years we've come up with more efficient machinery. Definitely become a bit more computerised, and the machinery we have, a lot of it's manufactured in Germany. It's very precise, obviously reliable, and goes day in, day out, but it's cutting edge technology. Like, we can produce products, we can stitch quilts, very detailed if need be, and it helps us put a superior product out in the marketplace.